I think welcome to Stress Out Stress Free. Thank you for watching. It is not easy to stop being stressed. It is part of our daily life, and for some, you know, some of us, we function only using adrenaline and getting things done on time. But when you are consistently under pressure after a day without taking any breaks, or pretending everything is okay, that will hurt you. We'll be right back after this message. Hi, welcome back. Welcome to Stress Out Stress Free. If you haven't met yet, my name is Vincent Moon, where I help people like you stay stress-free by changing one habit at a time. So today, we're going to be focusing on, do you need to, do you need to stress less? Yeah? Okay. So, what do you think? Do you need to stress less, or should we all stress less, right? Yeah. Stress leaves us, you know, struggling to fight illness and unable to sleep deeply. And it raises, you know, blood pressure, contributes to IBS, irritable bowel syndrome, and also, you know, it leads to like food intolerance, leaky guts, and also stomach problem, you know, and poor mood, you know, and irritability, and also increased anxiety. So stress, you know, aggravates or exacerbates, you know, PMS, and menstrual issues that can lead to poor sperm quality. And so it is obvious that we need to stress less, but how do we do that? Yep. We can change the way, you know, we respond to stress emotionally and physically. This is how we can sidestep and the detrimental effect of long-term stress, right? So what can we do, right? Like I've been saying, you know, get moving. What does get moving mean? Get moving, maybe, you know, not everybody, you know, enjoys moving. Not everybody enjoys movement. And, you know, but some people having exercise routine is a nice thing to do, and they enjoy it. One second here. Oh, yeah, let me forget. I almost forget to welcome you. One second here. Yes. All right. Hi, Steve. Good to see you. Let me see. Hi, Todd. Good to see you too. Nice to see you here. All right. Let's see. What Todd's saying? One second. Let's go up here. See what we have here. Okay. So you can hear my wife. She's in the next room. So, anyways. Tatsay, stress can be unhelpful when it's in thought form, because it suppresses the immune system, I believe. Yeah, that's true. That's true. Yeah. You know, stress can create a lot of things. Anxiety, anxiety is only a symptom. Yep. And collectively is every day. Yeah. So that's true. You know, it's, you know, stress, you know, you think it's what do you say? We kind of like immune to stress, like, you know, oh, you know, problem came up, and then you like, you stress away, and then it's like, oh yeah, that's normal, you know, you kind of get immune to it, kind of, right? So, okay, thanks for the response. Anyways, let's go back to movement, right? Yeah, you know, some people has an exercise routine, and also some people, you know, they like to, you know, you can even, if you don't like to dance or whatever, you can just, nowadays, like TikTok, you know, there are so many options, you know, you can just learn anything from TikTok, right? And also, if you want to learn dancing or movement, you can learn from YouTube too, right? Excuse me. All right. You know, you can do movements like, you know, water walking, you know, and of course yoga, and also hiking, you know. Some people think, you know, exercise is that you have to go to a gym, you just carry weights and lift weights, hang or do sit-ups or push-up. No, you can do a lot of stuff. As long as you do some movement, you create circulation in your body. Like walking in the park is good. You know, I have a park across the street and I used to walk, but once it's winter time, I have to move to the gym. And also, summertime here, we can use the pool, and it's like, you know, in America here, we have like the pools opens on the Memorial Day and it's closed down on Labor Day. So we have about 3 months to use the pool, which is great. You know, it's outdoor, you get some sun, which I've seen, which we are going to discuss a little bit later. Okay, so swimming is good for you. It helps, you know, the joint, like still stayed before, it helps loosen the joint. It helps, you know, you get a workout, but not really mess up your joints and stuff. So that, which is a great thing. And in the water, you just, you know, for me, it's just very relaxing and it's nice. Okay, let's talk about walking, right? If you say it's too cold outside, you can just go to a mall, walk in a mall, you know, you'll go to window shopping, you know. Window shopping for some people is relaxing. I mean, in order to get some exercise, you know, you do window shopping. If the morning is good for the eye, not good for the purse, but you know, you have to control your shopping habit. But anyways, you get to do some movement, do some exercise. So, and also you can, also, you can do window shopping and people shopping. You know, when it's something with the head or something with humans. So, it's when we see people, we're like, oh yeah, it's nice. You know, like during the COVID time, you know, you're not allowed to go anywhere. It's like so you don't have the human interaction or even human seeing another human. You know, you get the connection that you know, because we humans are social people. We have to be like around a lot of people, around people. So, oops. Anyways, let's see. Okay, and also, you know, your exercise can trigger what do they call a happy hormones? Huh? What does happy hormones do? A second here. Equipment malfunction. Hold on a second, be patient. All of a sudden it pops out, maybe my ear is too big. Okay, let's take a break first, then let's go see. Yeah, let's see what Todd said here. We may get used to it, but it needs an outlet, and it's never a good thing to carry too. Oops. It's not on there. Okay, there we go. Todd said, we may used to it, but it will not need an out. It will need an outlet. Yes, you have to let it go, because if it's everything, if you hold too much in you, it's going to explode, right? Just like water, you put it in a container, I mean in a bottle. And if it's too much of it, it's going to overflow or probably explode. The bottle will explode if it's there's pressure in there, right? And yep, I agree with you, Todd. Pool is great. Yeah, it helps. For me, it's like being in the pool or anything at the beach. I don't swim at the beach, but you know, hanging out at the beach by hearing the water and being in the pool makes it's a relaxing thing. So it helps like take your mind away, not the brain away. Okay, and also, I found that when I go swimming in the pool, more ideas pop out, and yeah, happy hormones make serotonin. Well, let's see. All right, let's go to the happy hormones and we'll find out. Okay. All right. What happy hormones is? Happy hormones are dopamine, serotonin, oxytocin, sorry, and endorphins, right? So, what does serotonin, I mean, one second. What does dopamine do? It's also dopamine is also a it's called a feel good hormones, you know, and a neurotransmitter that's an important part of your brain that rewards system, you know. Dopamine, I'm just reading it because I have to get this through you exactly what it says, right? So dopamine is associated with pleasurable sensation along with learning memories and also motor system function and more. Okay, serotonin is the hormones that helps regulate your mood and also, you know, as well as sleeping, appetite, digestion, and learning ability, and also for memory. Oxytocin, yes, I got it, is often called love harmony. Oxytocin is essential for childbirth, breastfeeding, and strong parents childhood bonding, you know. So it promotes like truth, empathy, and bonding in relationship. And oxytocin also levels generally increase when physical actions like kissing, cuddling, and also sex. Okay, endorphins is a natural pain killer, so which is help produce you put it your body produces and help reduce stress, okay, and discomfort. So and basically is reward is producing activities such as eating, working out, or having sex. Okay, all right, that's the happy hormones, yeah. Okay, let's see. All right, let's go to point number two is get the vitamin D, Todd said earlier, you know, spending time with pool is great. Let's see. Let's go to the chat. Okay, yeah. Steve said beach is very relaxing. Yep, it's true. When we were in Hawaii, we spent almost pretty much like 3/4 of the time at the beach, and it's nice because Hawaii is like we were in Honolulu, so Oahu. So when it's nice because in Hawaii, you know, you can go anywhere, like between half an hour, you can pop to the beach and you can go beach hopping too. It's because it's all close by, all in the same island, and in fact, you can drive around Honolulu. Yeah, probably an hour and a half, 2 hours. You can drive around the island, so it's pretty cool. So yeah, beach is really fun, and we used to go to beach, or I mean the summertime you love to go to beach. And let's see, where were we? All right, okay, beach is very relaxing. Yeah, and still say my favorite place to relax is one of them. Great. Yeah, that's true. And Todd said relaxer that opens pathway. Yep, something that opens the pathway, because and Todd said hi still. You guys know each other? Still said hi back. All right, that's cool. So good, you guys make friends now, right? Yeah, Todd, where are you from? Are you from Ohio, if I'm not mistaken? Anyways, okay, get some sun, right? It's, you know, your body needs to get some sun. What you need to get some exposure. What it does is can result in lower your serotonin level. Remember, and the lower serotonin can is a mood booster. Okay, and mood booster that can help you make feel calmer and focused. And you know, if you can get direct, oops, I have the picture here, one second. Oh, okay, New Hampshire, yeah. I probably, okay, never mind. I I think I thought you were from Ohio, but just New Hampshire, right? NH, yeah. Okay. Nice to see you. Okay. Let's see. Hold on a second. Yep, New Hampshire. New Hampshire is a nice place. We used to, when my kids were little, we used to go skiing up there in, I forgot the place, because this place has everything all included. My kids will be like riding around, having all the hot chocolate, and they probably have like, they have free hot chocolate at the lobby, so they probably have like 5 to 6 packs a day, or I think probably more. Every time you see them, they have eating there. Okay, all right, let me just transfer this here. Oops, all right, anyways. So if you can get any, let me just shrink it a little bit now. Anyways, okay. Okay, that's, if you can get any sun, you can always use the light therapy. I'm going to put the link here, link below, so that you can, you know, can check it out. And yes, it's an affiliate link. If you buy it or order anything there, it helps me to pay my bill. Anyways, okay. All right. So that's the, you know, you get the sunlight, right? Remember, if you can't get the sunlight, you can just go pop out to this link here. Let me show you one more time, if I can find it. Mm-hmm. Oh, okay. We saw another scene this way. Let's see. Yeah, go to truedark.com. They have the lights, they have the glasses, everything. It helps you take care of yourself. Okay, all right, let me just take that off. Okay, hi, we're back. Okay, all right, yes, let's see what Todd said. Todd said, I study myself with no thoughts in my mind to nature presents. Good. Yeah. I study myself with no thoughts. Okay. Yeah. Still say that sounds like fun. Yeah. New Hampshire is fun. I don't ski, but my kids ski, so they love it. And we spend time on the indoor outdoor hot and cold pool in New Hampshire. Yeah. Okay, yeah. Todd said, yeah, I might buy an infrared lamp for winter. Yeah, it's good. So what that does is instead of the natural light, you know, because winter time is get very little sun, right? So it's good, especially out in New Hampshire, because it's always cold. And also what this does is it's also the infrared light helps with pain, with circulation, and it's a lot of stuff. If you just click, I mean, if you just go into it, and I'll put a link after, I think, did I put a link down there already? Anyways, I will put a link down after on the description below, and you can just go check it out. It's pretty cool. All right. I usually have a infrared light. It's from China, where all those acupuncturists and also massage therapists from China, they use that to, they put the needle in, and also they put the light in to heat more, to put more heat on it. And sometimes when the acupuncturists do cupping, and they will put the light there to just help, infrared there to help the circulation process, and helps to quick and make the healing faster, I guess. Yeah. Okay. Let's see what Steel saying here. Let's go to the chat. Cold here to in winter. I shouldn't complain. Hell, but it's a good idea. Yeah. It's true. It's good. Yeah. I think you guys are colder than New Hampshire, I think. Yeah, because you're up north, right? Yeah. I haven't been to Canada, so you have to let me know. Okay, number three is cook a favorite meal. Cook a favorite meal with your loved ones. Okay. What happened is to boost all four of your happy hormones, you know, you do one of these and it helps create the happy hormones. Anyways, what it does is the enjoyment of eating with somebody something delicious, you know, helps trigger the dopamine and sharing with someone, you know, someone you love. It also will boost the oxytocin level in the oxytocin level in a person. So you know, when you eat something delicious, your dopamine will release your dopamine, and then you know, when you eat right, when something's good, like yes, you feel good. I mean, you want to eat more, right? So it's like it's the dopamine that's working. And you know, even if someone you love, you know, think about it, like, you know, you go out with your girlfriend, a boyfriend in the beginning if you're married, right? So you know, when you go out with them, you feel like, oh wow, you know, you feel the excitement, the bonding, you know. Anyways, you know, they will produce the oxytocin. Okay. And then certain foods impact the hormone levels, you know, like let me see, spicy food. Spicy food, what happens is it triggers the endorphin releases. So, and yogurt, beans, eggs, meats with a low content of, with low fat content, I'm sorry, and almonds, you know, it releases the dopamine. So, you know, these are the foods that links to dopamine release. No. Also, food with tryptophan, yeah, it will help increase the serotonin level. And also food that contains probiotic, such as like kimchi, yogurt, sauerkraut, it helps release the, influence the release of hormones. So these are the, cooking is very interesting, right? This it helps to promote your happy hormones. All right, okay. Let's see. Let's go to the chat here. Let's see what it said. Todd said, "Okay, he will check it out." Yes. Yeah. Okay. Yeah, we got. Oh wow! Still said we got to -2, -7. Well, that's cold. Anyways, okay, and. Yeah, getting dark at 5 p.m., 4 p.m. meets daylight sometimes. It's true, yeah. So, especially winter time, it's like crazy, you know. Sometimes I think 3 or 4 o'clock. Yeah, yeah 3 at 5 or 4. I think 3 for over here in New York, we have like 3 or 4. I think it gets dark. Now, it's weird. Sometimes you go out to work, you know, my wife goes out to work early. So you go out to work dark and come back also dark. Yeah. Giving is like tapping a gold mine. Yep. Okay. All right. So let's go to the fourth one. We talk about what did we talk about? Number one, we talk about get movements, right? Exercise. And now number two is what? Number two is get some vitamin, you go out. You know, in the sun or use the light therapy, and also cooking your favorite meal with your loved ones. Yeah, that's create all the happy hormones and everything, right? Okay, number four is practice a 5-4-3-2-1 technique. What happens is that if you have like a chronic panic attack. Chronic panic attack. All right, speak English. Hello. Anyways, all right. So use the 5-4-3-2-1 technique. What it does is you number one, five things you can, you know, look around for five things you can see around you, and then four is observe what you can touch. You know, observe what you can touch. So what this grounding technique is the 5-4-3-2-1 is it helps touch all your five senses. So number one is the eye, see. Number two is touch. Number three is listen. So let me go again, go repeat it again. So five things you can see. So five, look around for five things you can see. Okay, then observe five things you can touch. Okay, five things you can touch. And then number three is listen to three things you can hear. Oh, the bird is chirping. My cat is meowing. The water is running. And two things you can smell. Somebody's cooking next door. And I think my cat pooped. That's why it smells. Okay, anyway. And one thing you can taste. I think I'm going to have a banana. It should taste good and helps give me potassium and take away cramps, right? Okay, so that's like 5-4-3-2-1. So it's when you get panic attack, that's kind of like formula or something you can do to just calm you down. Okay. And number five is breathe outside the box. You know, when you get a panic attack, what happens is you will notice your heart will like boom, 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 boom. Heart rate increase. And all you need to do is, you know, calm down. Naturally, you know, it's an anxiety attack, right? So four steps you need to do. Number one is sit up straight, slowly exhale. Sit up straight, slowly exhale. Excuse me. Slowly exhale. What it does is help release the air from your lungs. And then number two is inhale to your nose for 4 seconds and then hold it. No, for sorry. Inhale for 4 seconds and then make sure you feel both lungs and abdomen. I mean, feel the both lungs and then you feel the raise in the abdomen, right? And then number three is just hold there for 4 seconds and then you exhale out through your mouth. 4 seconds and then release all the air in the lungs and abdomen, and then you hold for 4 seconds and then repeat the process again. So let's try it. Okay, all right, let's try it. Sit up straight, slowly exhale to your mouth, releasing all the air out of the lungs. Okay, then slowly breathe through your nose for 4 seconds. Fill up the lungs, left lung, right lung, and then until your abdomen feels like abdomen feels like it's moving. Feel your lungs there, so until you feel your abdomen is moving into your lungs. Okay, so let's go. 1, 2, 3. Left lung, right lung. And then your abdomen, you hold for 4 seconds. 1, 2, 3, 4. Then go. Release all the air. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. So that's what you do. Okay. So you release, do that 4 times or 5 times or whatever. So that's to help you calm you down. You want to do that one more time? Okay. Let's go. So sit up straight. All right, then blow out all the air through your mouth. Okay, then breathe in. Feel right lung, left lung. And then as you get to the abdomen, hold for 4 seconds. 3, 2, 1. There you go. Release all the air out. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. So repeat that 4 to 5 times or whatever, until you feel like relaxed and calm down. So that's box breathing. Okay. All right. Let's go to number six. Listen to music. This is, I think the music could be magical. You know, sometimes that's why they put it in the movies and stuff, right? When it's exciting, the sound will go like, and it says like, I have all the sounds, but I me see that. Like, you know, in the game show, what they do, like, they make you like, oh, make it excited, and it's like, you know, you want to skip you thinking, right? And then they have this one, oh, wrong, sorry. And then, you know, in some action movie. Oh, mysterious movie. Oh, it just can go. Alright, that's it. You wrong answer, sorry. Anyways, okay, so music and it looks like sound effects, but it's almost the same thing, right? So it helps it can make you into your happy mood. It's one of the happy mood booster, you know. If you listen to like instrumental music, especially like music that gives you chills, and what happens is like it increases your dopamine production. And you know, simply, you know, listen to music helps you enjoy and helps you in a good mood, you know. So, and you know, those are the positive thing, and it helps increase increase the serotonin, and you know, especially for musicians, what happens is, you know, when they experience the endorphin release and by creating the music and creating music, and then, you know, when they dance and performance in the drumming and leads to release more endorphin, you know. So let's go to the chat and see what we have. A couple of comments here. Typrotophan deficiency increase anxiety and irritability in human and may modulate aggressive and response to stress. Yep. Less of that, you know, so you have to eat more food with typrotophan, you know. Did I put it out?
Yeah.
Okay. All right. Presence can easily be cultivated with breath. Make sure you focus very, very well. That's true, yeah. So when you do the breathing, it helps you to bring you into the present. So that's, you know, into the present. So it helps you focus and be in the now time. Yep. Focus very well. That's funny sound. I try to use what the sound effect I have. So I was talking about listening to sound and music. So, you know, just try to put that in related to when you're watching the movies and stuff like that. You know, like Rocky, they will go like, ta-ta-ta. So it's just that boosts up the mood and create the atmosphere. Sinus breathing smooths. Special music comes and set the savage animal. Yep, that's true. So it helps relaxes yourself. So, you know, and also remember, music, listening to music, play the music can create happy hormones. Anyways, okay. So the last but not least, you know, plan a romantic evening. You know, why plan the romantic evening? It's kind of like help you stress, de-stress, right? So what it does is, there's more. Okay, all right. All right, so plan. Okay, I have to take this here. All right, still say, can't wait for some turkey. You're talking about food, right? Yeah, cooking and turkey, some, you know, when I go to this Disney World or theme parks, you know, they have the turkey drumstick. I don't know why I'm a sucker on the turkey drumsticks, because I think it's worth it, and it's like, it's easy to eat too. So turkey is pretty cool. Anyways, I love turkey, especially fried turkey. Ever since we bought a fryer, we just stay away from the oven turkey, you know. No more turkey in the oven. Fried turkey is the best, and it doesn't take that long to make. Okay. Can't wait for the turkey. Yes, your chill out music is good. Yes, chill music is good. And Todd say, I saw a pan full of turkey yesterday. Really? Yeah. Oh, over here, we have sometimes, once in a while, it's weird. Once in a while, you see like turkey like walking on the streets here. And I remember around Christmas time, I saw a bunch of turkey walking around in our area here. And that's a smart turkey because he flew in after Thanksgiving, you know. If he flew in before Thanksgiving, somebody might take the turkey. And we have a lot of Asians here, you know. Asians like to eat, and we do anything with animals or food, for food. Just saying, but this time, I think it's illegal here, so we never do that. Okay. All right. Still say nice. Yep. Still say Stoppelman is a good. I don't get sleep after. True. Even bake is good too. Yeah. Yeah. You learn to change sometimes, you know. My first like 30 something years in America, we've been eating like baked turkey, and then now once we found the fryer, that's it. It's easy. It's 1, 2, 3, and you know, who doesn't like fried food? But be careful, cholesterol. Anyways, let's go back to planning a romantic evening, right? So, oxytocin. Wait, hold on a second. Wild turkey are all found and stopped traffic. Oh yeah, up in New Hampshire, of course, yeah. You guys have wild turkey, you have the deer running, deer walking too. Yeah, I think in Canada you have the moose walking, right? Still? Okay. Did I put that up? Yeah, okay. Wild turkey are found, okay. All right, so. Nice, oops. Oh, your dad loves to bake turkey. Yeah. Oh, so no wonder you say you can't wait for turkey. Cool. Send some down here, down this way, okay? And Todd probably wants some too. Well, no, Todd has the wild turkey, so she's better. I hope you're talking about the wild turkey, not the whiskey, right? Anyways, let's go back to planning a romantic evening, okay? What does that do? You know, oxytocin, you know, is known as a love hormone. So, you know, and you know, simply being attracted to someone can lead to the production of, you know, of oxytocin. And you know, with the physical touch and cuddling and the kissing or having sex, the oxytocin production increases. So, you know. So just spend time with someone you care and can always help boost the oxytocin, and this help increases the closeness with your relationship with the person, and also feeling making you more happy and blissful, and you know, or even if euphoric. So okay, and that's pretty much it, you know. So if you plan something, plan a good dinner, it helps, you know. If you plan a romantic evening, you know, it helps to increase all the feel good, all the chemicals reaction, oxytocin and endorphins, and of course, you know, it ends up with having a good night. Anyways, okay, let's go to the chat and see what else. Goose, yep, okay, all right. Thanksgiving, yeah, LOL, yep. You know, for people like you still, you like turkey, that's the best time. You know, what we do is, after we bake the turkey or we fry the turkey, what you do is we take off all the meat. So we finish all the meat, right? The bone itself, the frame, the bone. What we do is we put in to a pot and make what we call porridge. And then we have that before everybody goes home. So this has like a tradition for us. So it's pretty cool. So in the Asian community or the Chinese community, we never waste food. So even the bones, because the bones has all the flavors and stuff. So what you do is you take out the bones and leftover some leftover meats here and there. So you know, you put it in a pot, add water, put some rice, and it makes it like kanji, or we call it porridge. Okay, That is with ham on Christmas. Yep. That's pretty traditional over here. Yeah. Turkey for Thanksgiving and then ham for Christmas. Yeah. All right. Okay. It's been pretty fun today. When we talk about food, everybody chimes in. Yes, that's true, because that's the easiest thing, right? You know, when you hang out, what do? You either drink or have some food, right? Or now the millennials, or I mean the younger kids, what they do is they hang out and Starbucks cafe. Okay. Still say that makes hemp pea soup after Christmas. Huh. That's a good idea. Maybe I can try that with the ham. Yeah, that's true. It's always good not to waste. Yep. It is. Yeah. Why waste, you know? After all, you work hard for the food, right? So, and you know, wasting is never a good thing. Anyways, okay. Thank you. So thank you very much for watching. You know, if you like this, please share with someone you know and you think it's helpful, make sure you share with them too. So, let me see, where did I go? Okay. Share with them and, you know, if this is the first time you're watching, please like the, give us some love, like the video, and, am I supposed to show something? Oh no. Okay. Like the video and let me see, what is it? Okay. Yeah, give us some like, and you want to support us, you can always go to buymeacoffee.com/winsomemoon. It's in the, I'm going to put it in the link below, so in the description below, so it's make it easier for you. And also, don't forget to stay stress-free by changing one habit at a time. And I see you in the next video. And Todd said, I'm glad for today. Good. Nice to have you here. Like, thank you so much for watching. And you know, it has been fun. And hope to see you more. And like usually Thursdays, I talk about stuff that we can do to de-stress. And Mondays at 9 p.m., we do the technical stuff, how to fix your neck, how to fix your shoulder, and you know, just share it with everybody, you know. Okay, great to share the moment. Thank you. Always appreciate you for watching, and we are like friends and we are like family now. So thank you for being part of the family. All right, and let's see if we can have some. Oh. And shout out to you guys. All right. Thank you so much. And I see you in the next video. Okay. All right. Let's see. Totally messed up. Wrong key. Alright, there we go. Don't forget to like, and I see you in the next video.